Hi, my name is Whitner Kennedy, and I feel connected to God through finding joy and purpose in my everyday life during uncertain times during this pandemic. Around this time last year, the pandemic was beginning in America, and many of us felt fear, confusion, uncertainty, and anxiety over what was to come over the next months. From forced quarantines, schools being closed, businesses being closed or forced to work remotely, missing family members that you're used to seeing often, and feeling generally stuck at home sometimes, it was a very difficult time for many of us. As many of you that are close to me know, I'm passionate about music. I love music, especially music during the Easter time. So when I was having my own feelings of anxiety, uncertainty, I was turning to, you know, songs of hymns of Easter and songs of Easter that provided hope and positive outlooks. And while I was doing this, I was on YouTube and came across a version of It Is Well With My Soul. This one was by Guy Penrod and David Phelps. The lyrics of that song seemed to immediately serve as a point of perspective, something that calmed me and helped me recenter myself during the pandemic and times of uncertainty, in knowing that God has us and God sent his son to die for our sins, and that it is well with our soul no matter what's going on in our everyday lives. So from that moment, it seemed to give me some perspective on, well, I'm stuck at home, or I can't go into work, I can't go have the meetings that I'm used to. And it turned into, this is an opportunity. Spending time with my family in every day-to-day lives and slowing down and realizing what's important, that family, friends, and those that you care about still care about you, even though you may not be able to see each other during the pandemic, and then having the opportunity to spend more close time with Sarah, Jay, and Grady. And even in this year, seeing the opportunity to pick up Jay off the bus from Pine Street and pick up Grady from school, opportunities that I haven't had in normal office life, have been a true blessing and have given me joy and perspective in my everyday life despite the pandemic. I wanted to close kind of this in some of the lyrics that I turned to in that song that are important to me and help keep me grounded. Whatever my lot, thou hast taught me to know, it is well with my soul. Now let's turn to the Bible as we continue our Lenten journey through the Gospel of Mark. Today's reading is Mark 6, 1 through 13. And he went out from thence and came into his own country, and his disciples follow him. And when the Sabbath day was come, he began to teach in the synagogue. And many hearing him were astonished, saying, from whence has this man these things? And what wisdom is this which is given unto him, that even such mighty works are wrought by his hands? Is not this the carpenter, the son of Mary, the brother of James and Joseph, and of Judah and Simon? And are not his sisters here with us? And they were offended at him. But Jesus said unto them, a prophet is not without honor, but in his own country and among his own kin and in his own house. And he could do there no mighty work, save that he laid his hands upon a few sick folk and healed them. And he marveled because of their unbelief. And he went round about the villages teaching. And he called unto him the 12 and began to send them forth two by two, and give them power over unclean spirits, and commanded them that they should take nothing for their journey save a staff only, no scrip, no bread, no money in their purse, but be shod with sandals and not put on two coats. And he said unto them, in what place soever ye enter into the house, there abide till ye depart from that place. And whosoever shall not receive you, nor hear you when ye depart thence, shake off the dust under your feet for a testimony against them. Verily I say unto you, it shall be more tolerable for Sodom and Gomorrah in the day of judgment than for that city. And they went out and preached that men should repent. And they cast out many devils and anointed them with oil, many that were sick, and healed them. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.